Welcome to the Frank Prince Show. I'm your host, Frank Prince. Only on Madhouse TV. I want to thank last guest, Madhouse TV owner, Tommy Maher. Thank you for being on my show. And I just want to shout out that he has an event coming up on August 1st at Sunset Grill. That's in Massapequa with his band, Virtual Signs. Vital Signs, there you go. What? Hey, when did this happen?
I did it in the last 30 seconds.
I also have special guest from Madhouse TV's own show, Date Night.
Yeah!
Chrissy.
Oh, thanks for my name first.
Decca and Connie Henriquez.
Henriquez.
Wait, I love
that.
I don't
know.
I'm married to Eric Decker and you got your
name. Come on. There you go. Welcome Henriquez.
Thank you.
Prince
Thank you for letting me be married to Eric Decker. I appreciate it.
Oh, yeah?
It. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I feel like this is the best show ever.
It says the best show ever.
Guys.
Go ahead.
Don't blow out the speakers. My mom. You blew out the speakers last time. Not Connie, but you did, Frank.
I did?
Yeah, when you did the best show ever.
No.
You blew them out, guys.
No way. There's no way.
Yep.
A chance.
My mom had to shut it down. My dad had to restart it.
Damn.
You did. You blew it out.
This is the best Frank Prince show ever.
Why don't you have your picture up?
I don't know why my picture ain't up.
What's going on here?
Yeah,
where's
that's messed up, man.
We should have had our logo.
I know. We should have our logo.
I don't know what to do. I'm like, there's no pink.
I don't like it. There's no pink.
No.
Tell us about yourselves.
No. You know what?
Come on.
You know what? No.
Come on. Yeah. Come on.
You know what, guys?
Come on.
You're the interviewer now. So you know what? I'm flipping it back on you.
Chrissy's got a BF here.
Who is this guy in this
I don't know. You brought him on. Does he talk?
He's our guest.
he's very nice looking.
Spooking me out.
He has a great stance.
He's very Tom Cruise in the statue.
You know what, you're right.
Mm-hmm. I like
Tom
Cruise. I like him, guys.
Yeah, me too.
He's a little weird
with Scientology, but
you're right about that.
He's hot, but he's weird.
Did you watch the documentary?
No, I wanted to.
I started to watch it. Did you watch that?
No, I didn't watch it.
It's very interesting.
It is. Actually, to have something that really gets people's attention the way that Scientology does is crazy.
But they're a little cuckoo about it.
They are. They're a little
John
extreme.
John Travolta, right?
Isn't he into that? He totally.
But I'm into all that stuff.
Oh, it's interesting.
I believe in God, guys. I don't know.
All right, so tell us about
that. I love that he doesn't even care.
Let's go.
Wait, we only got a half hour here.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Come on.
Sorry.
It's not an hour show.
We're used to an hour show.
You made us wait a half hour.
Come on.
I know.
Well,
we were here at 6 o'clock.
So I was outside, you know?
That's true. You were waiting for us.
We made it.
We winged it. So tell us about date night.
You were on it last week.
You were.
What'd you feel
date
about?
Date night.
Tell us about the show.
Date night is the best show ever on Madhouse TV that gives tips and tricks for single chicks to start loving life.
Yep. Then you were one of the single chicks.
You were.
Last week.
You were. Did you love it?
How did it feel?
Wait, so Frank, did you have fun?
I had my hat on.
Did you have fun on our show?
Yeah, I had a blast on your show.
Totally.
You having fun on my show?
Without a doubt.
That's a great thing. You're awesome.
I love you too.
Tom Cruise here. It's like perfect.
Top Gun. Look, he even has a sheet.
Chrissy was slapping him.
I love it.
Yeah.
All right, so tell us
about it. Did you learn any tips on our show?
Yeah.
You did.
Well, we talked about online dating.
Yeah.
We talked about dating
online
in general.
Dating. What's online dating?
It's a great resource to sit at home and meet people.
Through the computer.
I disagree.
I'm against it.
Me too.
I love online dating.
People have great stories, but with technology today, you don't know who you're really dealing with.
You're right.
On the other side of the computer.
You're right.
You're leaving your computer opened up for a virus.
Virus? How do we go from batch to virus? What?
Hey, that's the technology.
Yeah, but you have to go meet the person.
Yeah, before you get a virus.
You know.
Come on.
That's it. I got the flu. You know what I'm talking about.
That was a good one.
Oh, man.
She's pretty fine.
So, really, dating the internet.
Yes.
What do you want to know?
We love to date.
You love to date.
We love to date.
I know. Everybody loves to date.
Because we meet great guys.
We do.
Yeah. How do you meet them?
You know what? Online dating is a great resource. Listen, when you don't know people or you don't go out because you work a lot, when you have the resource of online dating where you can sit home, go online, do a profile, meet up with some people, I think that's great.
It's like a second job, though.
It's time consuming, sure.
It is. It's very time consuming.
But at least you're putting yourself out there.
Right.
The biggest misconception is that people think that online dating, you're going to meet like the end all be all.
Mm-hmm.
And right. what it really is about is that you're putting yourself out there to say, hey, I'm, you know, looking to meet someone cool. And then as a result, you meet people in different ways. Could be someone from high school. Could be someone from a mutual friend. Like, you mm-hmm. meet people in all different ways.
But do you think people are on there with the right intentions?
Well, yes and no. And if not, so what? You know right away. You know right away.
Do you check out your dates?
No.
Some people like, run the background.
I know. I don't do that.
I don't have time for that. All right. What am
some
I going to do?
Some people.
I call up the third precinct and be like, can you run this guy's
exactly.
license?
That's called weird.
Yeah.
And some people do it.
I know they do.
No, we don't do that.
Weird.
You just got to go. Weird. You got to go in person. And
go to happy hour. What's going to happen during happy hour?
Well, you get happy.
Right.
You should get happy.
Exactly. You get happy and that's it.
Why are you
doing this? And then you leave.
Right. If he's not a cool dude, you're like, oh my God, thanks so much. Then you're out.
Exactly.
So what qualities in a guy do you look for?
Oh, I like this guy. So how long do we have?
We got
I could go on for hours.
We got 25 minutes.
Funny.
Intelligent. Smart. Sexy.
Affectionate.
Totally affectionate. I don't think guys are affectionate enough.
Me too. I agree with you on that 100%.
And chivalrous.
Yes.
Open the car door. Like, that's sexy.
It is sexy. You'll get a lot from us if you would just open the
door. Totally. Like, simple things. Mm-hmm. Right?
You watching, guys? Take notes.
Open Call the car door. When you're walking on the sidewalk, walk on the outside.
Oh, I like that.
I know.
No one's ever did that.
It's a nice quality.
Oh, you're like, yeah. Well, where are these guys?
Listen.
They're out there.
They're totally out there.
No, I know.
Chrissy acts like they're not out
guys,
there.
Guys, I'm just dude's kidding like, around.
Yeah, I know.
I got class clown in high school. I don't want to reiterate. Yeah,
and being a great listener, like listening to what the other person has to say.
Communicating.
Right? Mm-hmm. And remembering. Like, say, hey, how'd you make out with whatever?
Right.
That's huge.
Being thoughtful.
Thoughtful, caring, and freaking funny.
And wanting to be and on the same page as you.
And totally on the same page.
That's the most important.
Totally. Working towards the same things.
Right.
If you are dating a dud... There you go. You don't want to date a dud. You want to date someone who's like afterlife in a very big way.
You want to date a stud, not a dud.
Right.
Stud, sure.
But a lot of guys are on there just to like hook up every weekend with a different girl.
Yeah, but you wouldn't attract that type of guy. You would know the difference.
How do you know the difference?
You could totally tell.
She's a life coach.
Exactly. I'm a life coach.
Some people can't.
I know. I think he's talking about himself. Connie, this is where you come in.
Not me.
Connie, you're the therapist.
You have to be clear about what you want. When you're clear about what you want, then when you go online, you look at things in a very different way. And you have to have fun with it.
Mm-hmm.
There's lots of cool people out there. Sometimes you go on a date, you're like, it's not for me, but you're still a cool guy.
Yeah, you're right.
You meet a new friend.
Or maybe you want to hook him up with your girlfriend.
Right,
I've done that before.
I've done that where I'm like, you're an awesome guy. Not for me, but I feel like you're an awesome guy for someone else.
You're right. I've done that.
Yeah, totally.
I don't think that's weird.
I think that's actually helpful.
It is helpful.
Yeah.
What do you feel about it?
What do I feel about it? It's a good resource.
Do you do it?
Do I do it? Yeah.
Do you do Match?
Match.
I think Match is like the best.
Oh, you do? Yeah, me too.
And did PlentyOfFish.com.
PlentyOfFish is free. We don't love free.
I don't like that.
No.
I want someone who's willing to invest.
Right. You're showing an investment by paying for the match. What is it, $100? 3 months? Mm-hmm. Whatever.
Yes.
Yeah, whatever it is.
Yeah, I think PlentyOfFish is like,
I like to go out, socialize, happy hour, different things.
Of course,
all right,
happy
good.
Hour,
and you're doing your comedy show coming up.
I know, come on. You're like freaking hottest comedian ever.
August what?
29th.
Where is it?
Sergio's in Massapequa.
Sergio's.
We're going. We'll be heckling you in the background.
That's right.
Do you care if I heckle you?
No,
we're not. We're not gonna be hecklers.
Yes.
We'll root you on, Frank.
I gotta heckle, guys.
That's a good.
Can I jump up on stage?
Nah,
you could jump up.
I can't get on stage. I'm jumping up.
You want to get on stage?
Yeah, I do.
There's no stage to get on.
There's no stage.
No.
Where do you do your performance?
Wherever I can.
What, in the bathroom?
Yeah.
7-Eleven, Dunkin' Donuts, where else?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
So where do me and Connie go for this? I don't get it.
I don't know.
We'll just do it from the table.
So tell us about yourself, Chrissy.
What, me being with Eric Decker?
No. Okay, you want to talk about it?
Well, guys.
That's what you told me.
Chrissy Decker? Wait, Chrissy said her last name was Decker?
No, he did.
She said last week. And when I was on your show, she said...
Chrissy Decker?
Did I?
Yeah, she said Chrissy Bogue Decker. How would I remember that? Oh, wow, okay. Yeah. So that's what I thought.
So did you think Chrissy was really married to an Eric Decker?
No.
Your memory's playing against me.
He's all news
he's
to
my
me.
Favorite Jets player.
Oh, okay.
Are you a football fan?
Yeah, I like the Giants. But I like this is going. I like all New York. It's going global.
I don't like
it. But it's all right. But I want to know about you. You know, on the mic with Chrissy.
What would you like to know?
Chrissy's a comedian.
I feel like I'm on a dating show.
Chrissy's a comedian.
You're an interviewer.
Chrissy's all right, let's see. My soulmate. So what do you decide?
First of all, she's my soulmate. Uh-huh. We got the match on Facebook. Uh-huh. And my 1,000 friends, I got Connie as my soulmate.
And we're like, oh my God, it totally makes sense.
It does make sense.
We dress in pink.
We do. And I really love her.
I love her too.
But aside from that, aside from that, what was the question? Because now I got sorry. Her beauty sidetracked me.
I see you interviewing all over the place.
Oh, with the UFC fighters?
Right.
I love doing that. I love it.
That's what I went to school for. Separate from your show?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. I do that for Ring Fever. Shout out to Ring Fever. I'm going to be at the Mariano Rivera Golf Classic on Monday. So I'll be with all the Yankees guys.
How cool is that?
I'm going to be with them.
That's great.
I'm going to be interviewing them. I can't wait.
How did you get into that?
Drive around the golf cart. My good friend Eddie Truck Warden. It always comes back to Eddie.
Eddie,
who still has not been a guest on our show.
Who will eventually be a guest.
And I ask him every time. He was in the UFC. He's in the UFC. He was on The Ultimate Fighter. So
which we love Ultimate Fighter.
Yes. He was on a reality show.
Okay.
Okay. And now he's in the UFC. He won the whole reality show. So during that time, there was a video crew there filming him. So I became friends with them. And then it all started from there.
How long have you been doing it?
Like 2 years now.
2 years.
Say.
And Chrissy actually went to school for this. So she is like a pro in journalism.
Yes.
Great.
I'm the next Erin Andrews, like guys. I'm going to be on the Jets sideline.
There you go.
Reporting.
Where did you go to school for this?
LIU Southampton.
How long?
What do you mean? I have a four-year degree.
Great. That's great.
She went 10. Well, 10 years.
I don't know.
I went for one day. I was like, guys, I'm out. Can I just have my degree? Thanks.
Peace
I'm
out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I got class clown in high school. That's important.
That is important.
All right, guys.
Shows how funny she is.
Yeah.
That's great.
She's all right.
She should do stand-up.
I know. I want to.
I feel like we're doing stand-up right now.
No, we're doing sit-down.
Can I open up for you on August 20th?
No. Totally.
Let me open
that
up for you.
That would be amazing. And then she would bring her D-Light mic.
Yes. Let's do it. Come on.
Nah.
Why? Why are you against me opening up for you?
I'm not against it.
I'll bring Tom.
Tom.
There's kissing, guys. Guys, I did it.
They're
it
was rolling good. At
he
home.
Was, it was a little cold.
I love it.
He was a little cold. I don't like it. I like a little warmth to the lips. Go ahead, Frank.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead.
Am I throwing you off?
No, you're not throwing me off.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Where I love how you have this new set, and we don't even get this.
Well, I feel like it's our set without the pink. I don't know. I feel like...
yeah, I don't like it. I don't like it one bit.
It's a little too cold.
Feeling. Yeah, Frank, you need to jazz this up.
Yeah.
I'm going to jazz it up.
Add some, like, accents.
Accents?
Not Tom. Like, something else, maybe.
Yeah.
Well, Tom was just brought in. I wonder how
we should throw Tom in as a prop.
We totally should, actually. We should put him on
instead of the tree. Love, Tom.
Well, we're going to be taking the commercial break. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
I'll hug Tom.
For professional motorcycle transport and towing, think Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing. Proudly serving all of Long Island, we feature expert handling and 24/7 service. So send a limo for your toy with Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing.
Galaxy Luxury Coach is a full-service limousine and party bus company. Family-owned and operated, we are an industry leader with over 25 years of experience in providing best-in-class luxury transportation for your special event. Whether it's your precious wedding day, an all-day wine tour out east, your high school prom, that special birthday, or just an amazing night on the town, our professional chauffeurs stand ready to ensure your special event is truly special. Galaxy Luxury Coach has one of the largest and modern party bus fleets in the New York area. Our party buses are simply nightclubs on wheels, concert sound systems, light shows, lasers and strobes, multicolor LED lighting brilliantly lights your party bus inside and out. For corporate and more laid-back events, we will cater to your specific needs and requests. What sets Galaxy aside from all others in the luxury transportation industry is our attention to detail in customizing our services to your special event. At Galaxy, it's all about you and your guests. Galaxy customers return time and time again because they know they can trust Galaxy to help deliver those lifetime memorable moments. Step aboard and let your Galaxy experience begin. Galaxy.
We're back! I'm on a date with two beautiful women. I feel like I'm in therapy. Here you go.
That's right.
Not with me,
style.
Right?
No.
I can't believe it, guys.
No, Connie.
Those roses are beautiful.
They smell dead. I'm just kidding. Good.
No, they're lively.
They're lively.
Like you.
I'm very lively.
I know you are.
Right.
You got us
Where'd
roses and everything. You got us roses, Tom Cruise, the Jungle Bush.
Well, she was responsible for Tom Cruise.
That's right, guys.
I spot a woman in.
I spot him from afar. Okay, Connie's going to give us some relationship advice.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, let's hear relationship advice.
I think Frank just brought us on here because he really wanted to
know
for himself.
I know, he's
supposed to hang out with us. No.
Relationship
advice? For people out there that want, you know.
What kind of advice do you want? I think relationships are amazing. I think if you have an amazing single life, then it only makes sense that you'd have an amazing relationship.
How come relationships sometimes don't work out?
Because it's not the right person. Very simple.
She's always going to have a good answer.
She's got a great answer.
Yeah, she always will.
Listen, every
person... She's always right.
Right.
Why is it tough to date, though?
You know why? I think because people aren't clear... People aren't clear about what they want.
Mm-hmm.
People just want... This is the thing. You need to have an amazing time being single. I love being single. I love being in a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
I love them both. Obviously, being in a relationship is a lot more fun, but being single could be totally fun. So I think you have to be clear about what you want from a relationship. I think sometimes people are so hard up for a relationship that they're like, oh, I'll take anyone who loves me.
Right.
Like that, I want to throw up.
Right.
So you want to be really clear about the qualities that are important to you.
Right, not and subtle.
No, totally. And then every person has different qualities that are really important to them. And if you're clear about it, then you're more likely to attract that type of person. But if you're all over the place where you're like, oh, I just want to be loved, then you're going to attract a bunch of crap. And I think that's the biggest problem. People are not clear.
And you should write an appreciation list. Like,
well,
you
yes, I do that. Yes,
tell Frank to do
clear.
It.
Yeah, you should write a list of all the qualities that you want. And the best way to do this is you think of everyone that you've dated and you think the shit qualities that they had,
mm-hmm.
and you do the opposite. So if you have a girl that doesn't appreciate you, what do you want to do? You want to be appreciated.
Right.
So you say, you know, that's a quality that most people don't even think about.
Mm-hmm.
You know, most people think about, I want a girl who's hot. I want a girl who whatever. But there's so many amazing qualities that people don't give, you know, credibility to.
Mm-hmm.
So if you say, hey, I want a girl who's emotionally connected. I want a girl who has her own money. We get it. I want a girl who's successful. I want a girl who's hot, but I want a girl who's, you know, appreciative and independent. Like, there's so many qualities that people don't even think about that are super important.
The simple ones.
The simple, well, simple meaning what?
Right. Everybody's looking way above and beyond, but there could be simple qualities.
Just be clear about it, you know? There's no quality that's right or wrong. Some people like different things, you know? But if you are able to write it down and say, oh, I never realized. And sometimes you have to date someone to say, hey, I never realized that was really important to me. And that the fact that they didn't do it, that's something I really want.
You used to say that to me all the time.
Totally.
Yep. She's a good friend.
That's great advice.
That's right.
She's a good friend to have around.
Exactly.
Yes, that's
when you're
why
dating.
The show is date night.
That's
exactly.
Right. That's always the best show ever.
Maybe we should bring you on. As like the Bachelor.
We should. But you have to get clear, Frank.
Yeah,
what do you want in a girl? Let's hear it.
Right now, I like the single life.
Oh!
I like the single life, but what I want in a girl
is
honesty, trust, understanding.
You don't want someone who's funny
loyalty.
Like you?
Right, but what else? So, you know what it is?
It doesn't matter about the funny.
But it does. Did you ever date a girl who's dry?
Oh my God, you'd have
yes,
a heart
attack.
Right, so you want a girl that's funny.
That's what she said, guys. No, I had to do it, guys. I had to do it. Sorry. All right, go ahead, Frank.
Yeah, it makes you work harder.
I had to make a laugh.
No, but that's the thing. You shouldn't have to work hard in a relationship. A relationship should be easy. It should be effortless.
I like what she's saying.
You don't want to work hard. You want a chick that's freaking funny.
And a guy.
And
vice versa.
I mean, listen, we're totally...
It should be easy. I don't think there should be any...
It should be twins.
Yeah. She's my soulmate.
Yeah, can you imagine we
I'm going to marry
twins?
Connie.
I know, exactly.
It's legal now. I'm marrying her.
So you want to be... So you don't want to take qualities like that for granted. You know, funny is a quality.
Mm-hmm. That's the most attractive quality.
Oh my God, totally sexy. Funny is sexy.
You don't want someone boring and serious.
No.
Totally. You want someone that's spontaneous, have fun. Yeah. Oh my God, you know, whatever.
Be loving and affectionate and funny.
And affectionate. Right. Affectionate is like key.
It's key too. Yes.
Totally key. Hold the girl, you know, hold her hand. Like, we love that shit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly. Why aren't you doing it, guys?
Yeah, why aren't you doing it?
Guys, why aren't you doing it?
Guys, why aren't we doing it?
No, a lot of guys do it. A lot of guys do it.
Is he doing it?
A lot of keepers doing it.
He seems a little cold, though.
Yeah, I don't like it.
I see a lot of old couples doing it. You know?
Because they
really
get it.
Great.
Because they appreciate.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what it's all about.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I think people just get...
jaded?
That, and I just think there's too much variety out there, so they just think that they can have whatever they want, different people every week. They can have somebody different.
But you know, I mean... Listen, there are a lot of people out there, but you know there's certain qualities that are super important, and when you get them,
right,
you're like, oh.
But I just think that people think that, like, people are replaceable. They could be like, oh, all right, well, forget it. I can just find the next one. You know what I'm saying?
I don't think like that.
I don't think like that either. But I think a lot of men think like that.
You think so?
Yeah.
I think the men that think like that are not the men you would want or I would want.
Correct.
So you're right. There are a lot of men out like that. But that... You could totally tell, and you're like, whatever. That's when they have no clear understanding of what they want.
That's true. That's very true.
So, yeah, it makes sense. They're out there.
Besides internet dating, where are some other places to meet people?
I think you just tell people that you're single, and if you're cool enough, people want to hook you up.
Tell your sister, your brother, whoever.
Yeah.
And don't be desperate about it.
That's the thing. People are desperate. Oh, my God, I want a boyfriend, whatever. Just have fun. The more you interact, the more you social. People are like, oh, who's that chick? Or who's that guy? Oh.
Right. Like, look how many people we meet every time we go out.
All the time. We meet awesome people.
You don't? I'm sure you do, too. You go to the comedy shows all the time.
Yeah.
You're a star in your own
right.
Come on.
You're right.
So leave it all up to the universe.
Exactly.
That's right.
Exactly. That's what she always says.
Yeah, well. I didn't steal it. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Why are you stealing
it? I'll lend it to you.
Aww,
lend it.
That was nice.
It's a great therapy session.
I know.
What is this?
We wanted to having more fun into therapy now.
I love that this is his own personal therapy session. You're ruining my Tito's time. What's going on here, guys?
Oh, come on.
Guys, what's
Tito's
going on?
Time?
What's next?
Come
what's
on.
The next question?
Brooklyn Mike.
Anything else?
Would have been purchasing us another. Go ahead, Frank.
All right. Besides
that, followers,
you know.
Yes.
No, women and men.
I'm not an expert, but go ahead.
A lot of people like to play on each other. Like
meaning,
it's... I'm trying to think of the proper thing.
All right, I'll say. All right, this is the thing. When you meet the right person, you don't have to play games.
Correct.
When you have to play games...
There's a lot of game players.
Right, but that means it's not the right person.
A ton of them.
No.
But they trap people, and they make you think they're the right person... And they're not. You find out later in life.
But
I know
a lot of people went through that. But you're the only one to... First of all, you give people too much power.
Mm.
When people are in a relationship, they give the power to the other person. And not to say that they aren't great, but you need to say, hey, this is what I want. And if you can match that, great. And if not, there's no hard feelings, but you're just not the one. So what happens is people give their feelings away like, oh, I want you to be the one.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't work like that.
Right.
You're going to date a million people until you find the ideal one based on where you are, but I think that...
How do you think you'll know when it's the right person?
I think you know. It's easy. It's effortless. I think it's fun. Mm-hmm. I think that...
Guys, I'm switching. I'm becoming better. I can't help myself. Good.
You know, it's...
You're the one with the advice.
You don't have to play games. It's like, I like you. You like me? Cool. Let's see how it goes.
Right.
There's no... Right. And the other thing is people are so hard-pressed to get married. So you go into a relationship, like, oh, we're going to get married, we're going to have kids. Screw that. Just, like, go into the relationship, have fun, see how it goes. If it works, great. If not, no hard feelings.
Right.
And then you do that, and then when it's time for that person to be that ideal person and marriage is the key, then you know. But don't go into it with that feeling.
Right. Is that what you do?
No, I go in with feeling.
You do?
Yeah.
With feeling?
Well, but will you go in, yet. Like, thinking this person
is like my wife?
No, I just take it
You take
slow.
It as it goes. But you feel...
A lot of people work a lot, and you know, and they don't have time.
But
so.
You want someone who works.
Right.
Oh, you don't want
Not
someone...
Not 24-7. You, want somebody, you have to have time for the person.
You want somebody that puts the effort in to see you and want to see you and make time for you.
No matter what.
Of course. And if that person's not doing it, then
it's not the right person.
Right.
Okay.
It's That's it.
It's
That's
excuses.
All you got to know.
Right.
There's a lot of that going on.
Then I wouldn't waste my time.
No,
I wouldn't even bother.
I'd be like, totally, adios, amigos.
Yeah. That just, they're telling you.
Right, when you really like someone, you make the time. Yep. Even if it's 11 o'clock at night.
Yep. Mm-hmm. That's how I would be.
Right.
I don't care if I was working
Who cares?
Till midnight.
I have less sleep now than I have in my entire life. And guess what? I'm cool with it.
Yeah. Because when you really like the person, you want to see
them. You work it out.
Time.
Yeah.
Who needs sleep?
That's
I'll sleep
right.
when I'm dead, guys.
We don't exactly. need
guys, I'll sleep when I'm dead.
Exactly.
Well, I want to thank you both for
being on the show.
It's over.
I love that we ended
on
sleep, but I'm dead. That's what we ended
on. That was the quickest show ever.
Absolutely.
The quickest show ever.
Ever.
From the best show ever.
Exactly.
Thank you both for being on the show.
We love you, Frank.
Thanks, Frank.
Thanks for having us.
Don't forget, guys, tune in Friday night, date night, 7:30. Madhouse TV.
We don't know where
I know, I totally stole that from you, Frank.
We're still on.
Good, Frank.
She just said it.
Oh. Yeah.
Tune in Friday night, 7:30,
date night.
ManHouseTV.com.
Maybe Tom Cruise will be a guest.
He totally is going to be a guest. He's our new...
I made out when I'm
He's
guest.
Our new...
That's it. We got to wave goodbye.
Bye.
Ciao.